NC in the place to be. NC.
Hi guys and welcome at my channel. I just want to show you how you should put your hit spreaders back, because I have showed this on my on another video, on a German video, and this is just a quick video that you guys can see how you should put your hit spreaders back. So the most important thing is, when you have opened your PlayStation, it doesn't matter if it's a fat edition or a slim edition, when you have opened your PlayStation, then you just take now a razor blade or something like this one here, and the first of all you need to do is to mark the positions where the hit shield was before. So you take this razor blade here and you make here a sign, yeah? You go over here, you cut a bit down, and you cut also this part here, okay? And then you can go here diagonal, you cut here again, and here. You just need to mark these positions that you know where you will need to put the hit spreaders back, okay? If you want, you can mark all the four sides here and here and here, and then you can also mark the side where the CPU is sitting. On this model I will just do the CPU, because it's only the CPU that makes problems here. But if you guys want to cut hit shields or EHS hit spreaders of the PlayStation, then you should mark all this side where the CPU hit spreader or the chip hit spreader was sitting before. This is one of the most important thing. You don't need here super glue or whatever glue. That's one of the best we can say parts, or one of the best options where you can replace your hit spreaders back. You don't need any glue, really not, okay? You don't need glue, you don't need to put the hit spreaders back and all the rest, okay? I will now just cut quickly the CPU hit spreader, and then I will show you how to put them back, and you can do the same for the RSX, okay? On this PlayStation here, I just need to do the CPU, but you guys can do the same thing also on the RSX, okay? So I will pause now, I will clean all, but just clean it when you have marked your points, okay? I will now clean this all and I will show you the positions that I have done now, just that you guys can see how this will look. This is now a PlayStation 3 Fat Edition, the CECH C04, C03, C01, a lot CECHC versions has this problem of overheating. The mostly fat editions are the CECH A, C, and some others like L and H models. They are really running a lot hot, we can say, and they get mostly we can say a yellow light of that problem. And on this year I will now fix it all, and the PlayStation here, like I told, has problems on the CPU side. Now I will clean this all, I will record again. Guys, I have now just cleaned the part where the CPU is sitting, and just that you can see also, you can see here we got here other colors on the metal, on the cooler itself. So here you can really see the CPU is running damn hot. Yeah, it's on fire. Burn, motherfucker, burn. Yeah, the most problems comes from the CPU side, and when the CPU is running cooler, we can say, then the RSX will be the next one. But yeah, as long the RSX is running great, don't open it, and just let all like this. But the CPU is the most and one of the biggest problems on the PlayStation 3 Fat Editions, and also on some older Slim Editions, we can say. But yeah, now I have recorded this here, just that you can see, let me focus, yeah, Now you can see how I have marked it, yeah? Like I told, just take a razor blade like this one and mark or cut the signs, we can say, just that you can see where you should replace the CPU heat spreader, yeah? Okay, on this side here we got the CPU heat spreader, but you just do the same also on the side where the RSX is sitting. I have also marked the RSX just to be sure for the next time. Maybe this guy here will have some problems too, and one day maybe he will ask me again if I can, yeah, fix him something or whatever. And so I have just marked it for the next time. We never know, this PlayStation maybe will come again one day to me, because the RSX will be the next problem, we can say. But the guy just wanted that I cut the CPU, and that's why I will let this one here. And you should also let the chip that makes no problem, you can let it, okay, really. So if you have multi-man running, or if you can see the temps, and you see the CPU is running on about 85 degrees, and this just in idle, we can say in menu, about 30 minutes, yeah, then you can see that the CPU is really getting totally hot. Totally fucking hot. And the RSX, if you see, it's running about 55 or 65 degrees. This is all just okay. It's not that, yeah, it's not that high. But if you see it's running all about 75 or 85 or higher, then you should, of course, cut the heat spreaders out, add new thermal paste or compound inside there and also outside. Okay, now I have just cleaned it here also again with you that you can see the RSX is sitting mostly more down. Yeah, you can see that. Okay, so here we go. I had to focus it again. So here you can see all the sides where I have marked the RSX. So next time, if I maybe need to open it again, next time I know it where to replace it, okay? And like I told, the RSX is sitting always a bit more down as the CPU. Let me put this away here. I got so much stuff again here. And now I will show you this here also, okay? Now you can see that the RSX is more up as the cell CPU, okay? You just need to turn it around because the cooler was, we can say, on the other side. And here, like you see, this is the RSX, so you can see it's a bit more down as the CPU, okay? Now I will clean boot, I will clean the CPU, I will cut it, and then I will also show you how to replace it with thermal paste or thermal compound, so that you guys know for the next time what is the best method to replace your heat spreader spec, because a lot guys sometimes still do that with super glue and all the shit, and you really don't need any glue, really, believe me guys. Normally you just need to put them back, and the most important is that the heat spreaders gets a lot pressure on that, okay? The heat spreaders needs to get a lot pressure on here, otherwise the heat will not go down to the cooler, and the, yeah, we can say the fan cannot be able to cool the CPU heat spreaders when the heat shield here is not sitting perfectly down with a lot pressure, okay? That's the most important, and that's why I will show you how to do that really just perfect, like a boss. So guys, I will now cut the CPU. I will try to cut it like here. Normally I just need to take the board in my hands, but yeah, I will try to cut it just here now that you can see also, yeah, live, we can say, with me while I am recording this. You need a special tool, otherwise you will damage your CPU because the CPU is really hard, you can say, to get open. Normally I never cut like this, I always need to turn it, and that's why I will turn this here just quickly so that I can cut it better, because here you should work really careful with a lot of patience and take a lot of care, of course, because this is one of the, yeah, hardest part, we can say. So, and like I told, your tool should be really thin, otherwise you will fuck your CPU. So, and let's see. Yeah. Alright. This is all now just cut it live for you guys. And here you can see again, the thermal past is really missing. Let me see if it's still recording. Yeah. Wait. Let's zoom a bit more down. Yeah, like I told here, you can see that the thermal compound is over the CPU. You can see also here, I don't know if you guys can see. Yeah, you can see that. Here the color here, you can see it's yeah, it was getting really hot here. And this thermal compound that is over here should be here, okay? If you open a great working RSX, yeah, so I mean, if the RSX was still running okay, when I would open it, you will see the thermal compound still on the chip, we can say over here, okay? But when you see that the thermal compound is not sitting over the chip anymore, we can say this is the die. When you see it's like that, yeah, then you can be sure that it's, yeah, the thermal compound is old and it's fucked up and the heat gets not transferred to the heat shield, okay? And that's why it gets inside hot and the thermal compound can not transfer the heat to the heat spreader and your PlayStation will get one day overheated and then you will have soon a yellow light of that. So guys, now I have just cleaned it all. Now you take this part again back and you put it back here. And the next important thing is now that you put the EHS heat spreader on the same place like it was, but also the direction, okay? So I have also here Apple new thermal compound here, and now what I mean is, wait, you can see that the back is here, okay? Here are these connectors, okay? This goes to the back, so that means you will need to put it like this, okay? And if you can see, we got here the open place, okay? Wait, so, alright, we got here the open place from the CPU. And that means you will need to replace the heat shield perfectly like this over here. So that means the open part is here on this side, on the upside. That means this is the side where this USB ports are. And you will also need to put the heat spreader perfectly like that back, okay? So I have also put here new thermal compound like always, and now you will need to put the heat spreader back like this, okay? Not like this and also not like that, like this and like that and like this, and you will really need to put your heat spreader back like this, because you can see here the old, yeah, we can say the silicone where you have cleaned it, you can see it on this place that this was open, okay? And that's why you will need to turn it now like that, okay? So this is really important, because if you turn it to a wrong side, that can be that the chip gets not 100% contact, because this metal parts here, they get another form with all the years, you know? That's why it's really important that you use the same direction. I will now put it down, and then we will press this with a lot of pressure down. I will show you how. So now let me focus first again for you guys can see all. I will now maybe put the camera more down. So yeah, I think it's okay for you guys can see that. All right, focusing, and here we go. Now I will put the heat spreader back on the positions where I have marked it. And yeah, go slowly down and attach it. Now press with your fingers with a lot of power down, okay? If you can feel that it's a bit swimming, then it's okay. That means the thermal compound is okay. When it's nothing swimming, then you maybe have, not added the thermal paste right, okay? Don't put too much thermal paste, but don't put, don't put it so empty, you know? So now, you can see this is swimming. I will need to take the camera to be able, or let's see, for you guys can see it better. Over here. And now you can see that the CPU is just perfect on all sides. When you go up here, you can see that I could move it a bit more to the right side, you see, like that. But this millimeter is not that important. The most important is that you have nearly put it on the same side. More important is on the RSX, because the RSX needs really to be perfect, okay? So take care that the RSX hits shield or hits spoiler is really just perfect. Now I will show you how to get a lot pressure down, okay? For that I will need again to put my camera back. Wait, I got so much stuff here. And let me turn it to that side here. Okay. So sorry, because I will need really to place my camera perfect, otherwise you will not be able to see that perfect. Like I want to show you right now. So the next thing is, now you just take a screw drill like this one here, or you just take a piece of wood, or you just take, like me, a hammer, but take the wood side, okay? Here. Okay? Don't take the metal side, you will fuck your heat spreader. Just take here the wood side. Now you hold the heat spreader with two fingers, and then you press with a lot of pressure down, okay? So I will now show you how. Let me zoom a bit back so you will be able to see it better maybe. So, and now I will hold it here with two fingers, just that I can see where the position is, okay? I will just hold this heat spreader that it will not move that much, okay? That's why I will hold it, and with the other hand I will press the heat spreader with a lot of pressure down. Wait. So, and now I will record again that you will be able to see that the thermal compound will come out. Wait. This is very important too. If you have not enough pressure, your PlayStation will run hot. So, okay, and that's why the pressure is one of the most important thing ever. Okay, I think this is now great. So you can also see already there is a bit thermal compound coming out. Okay, and I will now put a lot more pressure, because it will need to come on all sides out. And here we go! With a lot of pressure, just press it down. So, okay, are you guys able to see that? We got here a lot of thermal compound, okay? And this is fully, yeah, this is fully perfect if you got this small space free, it's fully perfect, okay? The most important is that the thermal compound comes out, because when it comes out, that means that you have a lot contact to the cooler. If you have not that much contact, the heat spreader will get hot and your PlayStation will get overheated again. So I will press a bit more down, and you can try, yeah, while you are pressing down, you can try to move the heat spreader on the right position. And yeah, wait, this looks good. It's still on the position, like I see. And now it's harder to move. You can feel it here, you see? It's not swimming anymore because it has a lot pressure. Yeah, and that's a good sign if you can't move it anymore. So I will let it like this because the rest, these screws here will do the rest. Okay, the CPU and GPU holder will now do the rest. Now just go over here. Still focus it? Yep. I hope so. Okay. You go here with toilet paper. And you just clean it here for the last time because this is also very important now. Alright. So, I have not forget to apply here new thermal compound on the RSX. I will quickly do that, but normally the video is over. The rest, you will be able to do it without problem. And one more important thing is, don't use here a cheap thermal compound. Don't use something bad for 50 cent or whatever. Just use something great like the MX2 or Arctic Silver 5. Okay, the Arctic Silver 5 to put over here is not that great because, if you want to open it next time, it will be very hard for you if you use Arctic Silver 5 over the heat spreader. But you can use Arctic Silver 5 inside the heat spreader. This is the best what you can do. I promise you this, guys. Arctic Silver 5 here inside the heat spreaders is the best what you can do. You don't need anything else, okay? And for the part over there, you just take MX2, MX4, or if you like, you can also take a cheap one. But the part inside is very important, okay? So I will now just put here some thermal compound and I will record again like a boss. So guys, here I am again, and I have, like I told, just apply here new thermal compound, and as I told on the CPU side, I have already done new thermal compound. I will now put it together. Like I told, don't forget. Need to zoom back. Okay, this is already back. Don't forget the position, okay? Look on the silicone where the place is, where the position is, and if you can see, it's up. And then you will need also to put it here up, okay? So, again for you guys, here, I hope you can see that, it's up. And we will put this now like that together. Okay, so I hope the focus is great. Now I will get in. Here we go. And now I will close it. So you can press here one or two times down. For the guys that has still problems because the PlayStation is very, very old, you can put over here a bit carton or a bit paper. That will help you to get better pressure, because like you can see here, you see that these parts here, they press the PCB down, okay, the platine, the board, this 4 feet, the small 4 feet presses the chip down. And on some models you will still have, yeah, we can say not enough pressure. And if you put here a bit carton, like, yeah, you can say this place here inside, the most important is the place inside, because you get here outside, you get a lot pressure, but not inside. And I got a video somewhere, I will put you the link up here, should come now here a link, but you will need to watch it over the computer, not over smartphones. If you watch this over computer, you will have here now a link. I will post you there a video where the chip had not had enough pressure. And I have tested this and I saw that this was really helping, okay? So that's why I will not just put it here. I will now take a cutter, wait, just like this one here. I will now just demonstrate you how you can fix this. Because when I'm recording, I will now also show you how you should do that. Just take here a bit cutter, and it's enough if you take one like this here, okay? Take a bit cutter from some cartonnage or whatever it calls in English, and then you cut it on the same space like the inside here, okay? So that means we got here, and you will need, wait, because I'm doing this now live for you guys. You will need to cut it here, and the other side is about here. Okay, wait, let me cut this again. So, here we go. And then you can see that this is now getting here inside perfectly, okay? You can let it like this, okay? The rest, when you press it down, this will get together, okay? Wait, let me focus again. So when you put the screws together, this here will get down, you see that? And this will put you a lot pressure everywhere, not just here on the outside, okay? This is not just a great tip and trick for you guys. You just do that if you have still problems with the pressure, like on this video here up, okay? Just look here on the video, wait, here's my finger. Here on this video, you will see a CPU that has had not a lot of pressure. And you can do this. You don't need to do it like on this video, okay? You don't need to do it like on this video. First, try this option with Arctic Silver 5 inside the heat spreader. And I promise you guys, this will work just fantastic, okay? But if you have a chip that is still working perfect, you don't need it. You just do it, like I told, if you have not a lot of pressure to the chip. Okay, now we will build it together. And I will now show you the last important thing on putting it together. You should close the screws one by one. Okay, just go here. You can hear it, when you turn it to the left, it makes click. Wait, click, you hear that? That means that it gets inside, the screw now is inside. Again, click, and now you can turn it to the right. And here you do the same, okay? Click, and now you turn it to the right, okay? So I have turned it one time to the right, and here one time to the right too. And you don't do this screw here till the end, and then the next, you just do it like me, you go here, you turn it one time, and here again one time, and here we go again one time, and here one time. Now you wait just about a few seconds. In the time you wait, this will press us, we can set the timer compound down. It will make a great pressure. In the time you let it wait, you can make now the RSX, okay, go over here. Now we will make the RSX. Let me see the camera position. Okay, I think it's good. So, and we do the next and the same thing for the RSX. One time. Wait. Click, and next time. Okay, and here we go again. One time. One turn, and again one turn, and here again. Now you let it wait here, you do the second one, or the CPU now again, and one turn, one, and one, you go now to the RSX again, and one turn again, and here again for the CPU, one turn, oh, here it's closed, and here it's closed too, you see? That was just perfect. And here again. One turn, I notice, is closed too. And here, one turn. Again here. Here, it's closed now. And here, it's also closed now. Here again for the CPU. Yeah, it's really close. And here, it's also really close. Okay? And you don't need more pressure. Really. Don't fuck your screws, because this is just perfect now. If you feel that it's not getting more, then just let it, because otherwise you will really destroy your screws and your cooler. Okay, guys. So, yeah. I think this was the most important for the last step. Like I always say in my videos, take this fucking PSU case out, because this shit here... Well, let me get open here. This shit case here gets so fucking hot. The PSU runs also very hot, and that's why the CPU mostly gets damaged, or we can say overheated. Okay, because you got, because of this PSU here, about 10-15 degrees more temperatures as on the side where the RSX is sitting. Because on the side where the RSX is sitting, there is just the Blu-ray device. The Blu-ray device gets not hot. But the fucking PSU gets damn hot. And that's why I have also a video where I have put this PSU external. And this was one of the best videos ever. The PlayStation was running very cool. Okay, so just take this shit out here. Take the dust out. Now you can just put it inside back. And you can now, like I always tell, throw this fucking PSU case away. Okay, now put it here together. And yeah, I already know this is working because I have repaired it all. Now I have done also the CPU heat spreader. I have opened it. I have cooled it. Don't forget the fan on the back side. Otherwise the fan will not turn. And then you will get a yellow light of that again. Now I will just put something under the fan, because it has more space. Normally I don't need to show you this, because the rest is okay for now. I have now just show you how you should put the heat spreaders back, and I have show you a lot more things, but the most important, like I told, was this. And let's check it out. Here we go. Still working all. I hope you can see the green lights. Wait, here. Ah, come on. Yeah. Whatever. I don't need to prove you anything, because this was the PlayStation that I have already repaired. Then I have cut the CPU heat spreaders. And the next thing what I will do is yeah, fan adjuster, like I always do. Yeah, with the small parts here. And then the PlayStation will run again for minimum a half year. I had a PlayStation from Holland. After my repair, it was still working about 1.5 years. And that's really great. Okay, guys. Wish you the best. Like a boss. Peace. And take care. Stay tuned on my channel. Subscribe something or somewhere here. Sorry again for my English. But if you don't like it, then screw you, motherfucker. Peace.
NC. In the place to be. NC.